What's on the docket today, everyone? Well, today is going to be a pretty awesome day, a day that I've been waiting for a while. I'm going to do a rear disc conversion on my Celica GT, 2001 Celica GT. That's what we're doing today. I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm going to walk you through it. And tips and tricks. Yeah. See you down on the ground. All right, guys. So once you get the tire off, wheel and tire, car jacked up, all that stuff, once you get all of it off, the first thing you want to do is take your drum off. Just beat it off. Mine came off pretty easily. Just got to wiggle it back and forth. You might need to take a slide hammer to it, whatever the case may be. Next thing you want to do after you get the drum off, because you want to set up yourself to be able to pull the brake cable. Okay, now the GT and the GTS brake cable, the same brake cable, so you don't have to worry about going underneath the car, dropping the exhaust, doing all that stuff. So it's the same cable. So, but like I said, you want to get yourself set up to the point to where you can take that e-brake cable off. Then after you get the drum off, you want to come up here to your hard line and disconnect that soft line, which mine is right here, and I routed up into the spring here so the brake fluid wouldn't leak and drop out all over the place. And then what I did, I took what would be your soft line. This is stainless steel line or whatever, or braided steel line. But what you want to do, what I did here, is I closed it off. So when I mounted this up, I mounted it up with the caliper. So this way, the brake fluid that's in the reservoir in the front of the car isn't leaking out and constantly dripping all over the place. Okay. When you break this loose, there's going to be brake fluid that comes out, 100%. Okay. But what you're going to do is break this loose first. Now this may be really, really tight. You might want to take some WD-40, let it sit for a while. I let it sit for a while and I still needed a pair of lock channel pliers here to get this, to even break it loose. Once I got it broken loose, I switched over to the flare nut wrench. I tried to use the flare nut wrench at first and it kind of ate up the nut just a little bit. So I stopped using this immediately, switched to the channel locks and broke it free, and then switched back to the wrench in order to do this. But yeah, once you got all this buttoned back up, take the caliper, move it out of the way. Then you're going to want to undo the four bolts that are on the back side of the hub here, and I'll show you that right now. All right, so here are your four bolts. This is the backside of your hub right here. Next thing you want to do is undo these four bolts so you can get your hub out. You're going to need the hub in order to, obviously, to put your wheel and tire back on. But it's only four bolts. I think these are 14 millimeter. So yeah, once you get these out, you're just going to wiggle the hub back and forth to get the hub out. So once you have your backing plate stripped down for the most part, and to where you can pull the shoes kind of out of the way, to get to the handbrake cable, there's a 10 millimeter bolt that's hidden right there behind the shoe itself. It's right there. So it's on the right side. So if your backing plate is up like that, it'll be over here. And then the handbrake cable stretches all the way across. It'll stretch all the way across to this. So when you get to this point, unbolt the handbrake cable here and then pull this spring back. And so it's set up just like a throttle cable. When you pull the spring back, you're going to unhook. You're going to go down, or you're going to go forward slightly and then down to unhook it, just like you would a throttle cable. All right, I got everything on the scale for both sides. So I got both calipers, both rotors, both backing plates, and the set of brake pads. So what you're gonna do is take this number that you see here and divide it by half, and that's how much is gonna go weight-wise on either side. So let's press down on the scale, and we're looking at 35.8 pounds. All right, guys. I got the drums off this one side. I got one drum and the backing plate. So I'm going to get this number. I'm going to weigh it. And then we're going to multiply this by 2. And we're going to compare it. So let's do this. Turn the scale on. 12 pounds. So looking at 24 pounds here total for both sides. So yeah, now let's see what we got for rotational mass versus rotational mass here. See if we are gaining anything there. So we got the drum right here, and just the drum by itself. Turn the scale on. Drum doesn't register. All right. It should. Let's see. Drum by itself is 7.4 pounds on the drum. And the disc is brand new disc from Toyota is 8 pounds. So what you need, long story short, are, boom, these right here, flanged M10 1.25 40 millimeter hex bolts. These are what you're going to need. These are a little bit longer than the stock ones. They're about 5 millimeters longer, and this is long enough to reach the hub and bolt the hub up and everything else. So this is what you're going to need. And as you guys can see, there's the factory Toyota bolt. There's the new bolt. Again, slightly longer. It's slightly longer than the factory bolt. And that's going to give you enough clearance. That's going to give you enough clearance to go all the way through and bolt, be able to bolt that hub up. So guys, I wanted to show you real quick why you needed the longer bolts, okay? I do have this piece off of the GT, which obviously this is the GT version, and I have it off of the GTS. So again, I want to show you guys why you need the longer bolts. So here is, you see that this has a lip right here. This is the GT one. So if you're doing a rear disc conversion on your GT, your XRS, your Corolla XRS, your Matrix XR, you're gonna have this lip on your mounting area, right? That lip is not there on the GTS at all, okay? Because this lip, right, is on the backing plate for your rear disc backing plate, okay? So that's why you need the longer bolts, all right? So you're essentially stacking two of these plates together. Now, your wheel will stick out a little bit further, but it's nothing really to concern yourself with at all, okay? So, I mean, that's fingers width, right? That's about how much further your wheel's gonna poke out in the rear. Again, nothing really to be concerned about or anything else. It's not gonna change any kind of characteristics about the car or handling or anything like that, but just something to keep in mind that you guys can pull this, which is the GTS one, and not get the longer bolts, or you guys can keep the GT version and get the longer bolts. It's up to you. All right, everyone, after you're done, you got everything bolted up and you got your brake pads installed, your brake lines put on, all that good crazy stuff. Last thing you do is bleed the system, and do yourself a favor, just get one of these simple little hand pump bleeders. They work really, really well, and you don't need a second person in order to help you bleed the brakes. It's all done straight from the pump with the power of a couple squeezes. So all right, once you guys get to this point, where there's no bubbles or anything coming from this area. The area might be a little further out too, but once you stop seeing bubbles close to the bleeder, it's bled. And the instructions say to allow up to 2 inches into the cup, and that's what I did. So you just crack the bleeder open and let it do it. Just let the pump and the air and everything do its job, and keep an eye on your reservoir. I did have to fill it up once. Yeah, I had to fill it up once to be able to do this. So, but yeah, just keep an eye on your reservoir and you're good to go. Like I said, once it gets like this, close the bleeder valve and go on to the next break. Okay, guys. So here's something I definitely wanted to show you guys. This is the anti-rattle spring for your calipers, all right? This can be a bit of a bear to figure out. It can be really frustrating. So as you can see, it wraps around. So I wanted to show you guys. As you can see, it wraps around. So what this piece does, this, I guess, what, half circle, quarter circle, okay, will go up against the pin and then wrap around the caliper or the brake pad like that on the outside, and then the clip will clip straight into that hole. Just bend it down in there and boom, there you go. You got your anti-rattle spring installed for your brake pads. Really simple. So now that I got the rear disc conversion done, I guess it's time I could put this on, right? Nope. All right, guys, I hope this video helps either some of you or all of you, or and it gives some of you guys the courage to do something like this on your own. As you guys can see, it's really simple. It's really easy stuff to do. It might be a little time consuming, but it's not a scary thing to do at all. If you guys found the video informative, thumbs up. If not, thumbs it down, and hit that subscribe button, and you guys know what to do from there. Hit that notification bell so you guys can see future uploads of when I either tinker on the Celica or on the Matrix. So, as always, guys, stay safe out there, and one more thing. If you guys have any questions, don't be afraid to ask. Leave a comment down below and I will answer your questions. If you feel like I left something out or something in the video didn't address something that you thought it may have, just leave a comment down below and I'll answer the question. But yeah, as always, guys, stay safe. Most important thing, love you guys. And as always, cut it out. Later.